Hi, sir. Colonel Lee Rosa. Welcome to Cape Canaveral. How are you?
I'm well, sir.
Very well. Thanks for coming. Yeah. Appreciate you.
Well, tell me about the SpaceX.
Well, our goal is to make a huge difference in space exploration. Try to make space a lot more like air transport. You know, if you think about it, it's been, from 1903 to 1969, from 1903 the Wright brothers first flew to 1969, for 66 years, our first part of like landing on the moon. It's been
So what are we doing here?
Well, this is the launch location for our Falcon 9 rocket by Dragon spacecraft, which you may have seen. Parked on the launch pad there. We'll do the first launch of this big rocket next
coming
month.
Up soon.
Yeah, next month.
That'll be exciting.
It's our great partnership that we have here between NASA, the Air Force, the FAA, and SpaceX. It's a really a great commercial government balance here. The state of Florida as well has pitched in, so it's really made all of this happen very, very quickly.
Right. The Air Force has been really helpful for us. So I do think on the FAA side, just as there is a revolution taking place, a big change taking place in the NASA plans and commercial spaceflight, that does need to be matched up the FAA on the space side, which isn't currently. I do think that is a critical thing.
Well, that's good to know. Yeah. John, FAA, we're going to have to get them involved.
We're going to take
them. Okay. There you go. Hey, have you met John Holder, my national?
Hi.
National Science Advisor.
Very nice to meet you.
And I'm assuming you know.
Yes, absolutely. Nice to meet you.
Okay, that's terrific. So was construction actually done here in this factory?
Yes.
Or in this
is where
space?
We did the final assembly of the rocket and spacecraft. So the manufacturing is currently done in California.
Right.
And then we do our testing of the engines in Texas, and then it comes here to the Cape for final assembly.
And this was an old Air Force launch pad, sir, that was accessed over to SpaceX.
Excellent.
A great partnership again to be able to provide them with a great capability and share the land here on a long-term lease.
So what's been the biggest challenge in terms of getting the Falconer going?
Well, the whole rocket's been built from the ground up, so that it's difficult to say that any one particular challenge has been greater than the others, because we've developed the engines, the structures, the avionics, the launch operations, all from scratch, basically.
Right.
I do think some of the regulatory stuff has been challenging, and that's where I think the biggest need is to make changes.
All right.
Yes, sir. And our number one concern, of course, is public safety.
Safety.
And we've been doing the best we can, but public safety is non-negotiable.
Absolutely.
In some places.
Absolutely. We don't want a rocket landing on anybody's head.
You got it, sir.
Right. And we absolutely agree with that. I mean, our goal is to make a much more reliable vehicle, first of all, and secondly, to make a big improvement in cost.
Now, in terms of use, the idea would be... In terms of use, I think the idea is that this would help to supply the space station.
That's correct. We've already been selected by NASA to perform the cargo transport function that the space shuttle was performing.
Right.
And that decision was made about a year and a half ago.
Right.
The big change.
This point?
8 years.
Eight years.
Yeah. So I did a company called PayPal before that. And
no, I remember.
Yeah.
But then Tesla as well. Yeah. You must have had like a lot of match fun.
Sort of engineering technology. Special thermal protection, because the real big breakthrough that's needed with rocketry is a truly reusable rocket. You know, if we're to make a revolution in space, it's got to be reusable. If you think about any mode of transport, bicycle, plane, everything.
It's just too expensive to have a disposable.
Exactly. Yeah. And thus far, it's been an elusive dream in space to create a truly reusable rocket. But that's what we're going to try to do with that. Kind of heat tiles for when the stage re-enters to survive the heat of re-entry. So on this flight, we're going to try to recover the first stage, and then later we're going to recover the both stages. If we can do that, and we can push it, it'll be
that the first flight will be the key to make sure that the
second stage is tougher because it's an orbit, so there's a full heat shield, a deorbit engine control during re-entry, but also there are pressure toward landing, and that'll be kind of the initial phase. And then the later phase will be to have it essentially fly back to the land site and land on a truck. And that section, so the rocket kind of puts that in a parking orbit.
Okay.
And it's about 100 miles below the space station or so.
Okay.
And then that little craft has got its little engines on it, and it maneuvers over to the space station. And,
at this stage it's unmanned, so you're going to be able to just control that.
Docking and then return to Earth and just land in the water just off the coast of California. Now, when we go to the manned version, the big change is we need a crew escape system, so sort of an escape rockets in case something goes wrong with the booster. And we're going to do something pretty radical there, which is to build the rockets into the spacecraft itself, so that. This is tough.
Hey, I'm not an engineer, but I can tell that's that's complicated. But you know, what's wonderful is to see getting the best possible innovation. And obviously, you know, we're going to try to see if we can accelerate this kind of collaboration through we put forward. So.
It's the right plan.
Good. Well, congratulations. This is terrific.
Thank you very much.
How's the car doing?
It's doing great, actually.
Yeah? How do you split your time between car and rocket?
Well, it's usually about 50-50. We should have the sedan on the roads in 2 years. And that, it'll be the best car on the roads by far. That's our goal.
I'm going to have to test drive it.
Absolutely.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thanks for helping us open Cape Canaveral space.
Absolutely.